guys, welcome to my channel. Today we are working on the neck hang. That's right, powder your neck up with rosin and kiss your skin goodbye because it's neck hang time. This can be a long process, but it is a gorgeous one once you do get it and a big crowd pleaser. Plus, it's going to strengthen the whole back of your body, so it is well worth working on. I'm gonna show you how to set up the move, how to do it from the air, and how to do some conditioning and strengthening exercises for it. But first, please take a minute to subscribe to my channel if you are not already, and check out all my other videos. I have lots of other tutorials for every level, and I have lots of videos about broader aerial subjects, all kinds of stuff over there, plus a really great community of people. So make sure that you check it out and subscribe. So let's start with warm-ups and conditioning. Make sure that you are warming up your neck before you do this move, of course, and then also do your same warm-up exercises to cool down. I like to do some head rolls in both directions and then gently pull my neck from side to side and back and front. This gives me a little bit of a stretch, but again, don't pull too hard because it's really easy to overstretch your neck in these directions. And for your conditioning, the best conditioning for this move is to simply hold up your legs and your back and your arms in the position that you will be in the air, and let the weight of your body fighting against gravity strengthen the whole back of your body. Also work on building back strength by doing these reverse crunches. Make sure that your neck stays in line, lifting your shoulders all the way up and then controlling them on the way down. This move is all about back strength. Your back, your glutes, your thighs, your hamstrings, everything is going to help hold you on the hoop. Another really vital part of this neck hang is your skin fold. This is where I found out that it's really difficult to film yourself doing a skin fold while the camera is in one of your hands. Am I in the shot? Am I? I don't know. Am I in the shot? So all a skin fold is what holds you on the hoop while you're hanging from your neck, or also the same thing for your foot hangs or your heel hangs. Because I was struggling so hard to film my actual own neck doing this, I decided to show you a skin fold with my arm. So here's the idea of what you're doing with your skin. Slide your skin along it so that your skin is naturally going to just fold, and that extra ridge of folded up skin will make a huge difference in your ability to stay on the hoop. You might also want to rosin up your neck a lot. To be honest, I'm not sure if I really do a neck hang or if I just glue my body to the hoop. It's debatable. To start practicing the neck hang, do it from the floor. Place the bottom of the hoop against the little bone that is the bottom of your neck and the top of your spine. There's a little bone that sticks out there, and I find that for me, that is the perfect place to start my hoop sliding up my neck. Then I slide my hoop about halfway up my neck and I throw my head back as far as possible. Again, you're gonna have that little skin fold from sliding the hoop up that is going to help hold you on. And you can start to lift your legs to the back. This is the same position that you were just doing on the floor in your conditioning. So really as far back as you can get your legs, the better. You're also holding on to the back of the hoop with your hands. And when you feel secure, try taking your hands off. Even if it's only for a half a second, that's the beginning of your process. Try challenging yourself each time to hold your hands off a little bit longer. When you start to be able to hold it a little bit on the ground, you can try it from the air. I actually find doing it from the air a little bit easier. I start sitting in the hoop, and then I wiggle my butt out of the front of the hoop as I hold on slightly below the middle of the hoop with my hands. When I get to the point where the bottom of the hoop is touching that little bone in my neck, I slide it down, I look up to the ceiling, I really engage all of my back muscles, I hold my legs behind me, and I throw my arms out behind me. The more of your weight you can put behind you, the easier it's gonna be to stay on the hoop. When I feel like I have to let go, I put my hands on the hoop again and can lower myself down with control. If you want to make the scooting your butt out the front of the hoop part a little prettier, you can try doing some walks in the air with your legs. This is a nice way to get your hips out the front of the hoop, but make it look like it's part of the choreography. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed working on the neck hang with me. Let me know how it goes for you. Make sure you tag me in your videos if you post them. And make sure that you subscribe and stay tuned to my channel. I do videos every Wednesday and Saturday. So make sure you subscribe so you won't miss any of the new stuff that is coming out all the time. On that note, I will see you guys next time.